So now I'm down. And they want to get it. So now, you're on the radio show, starting. Yeah. Just about to go on the big tour. How's the response been? So just recently started Cotton Club.
Cotton Club stuff. Cotton Club's another way of us to actually get people into this whole vibe that we're trying to push, this underground pop culture. You know, Boys and Bucks are also pushing it. There's a lot of us, you guys are pushing it with people and everything, you know? It's Cotton Club, I think. Firstly, the sound system is unbelievable. So that's out at Alexandra Theatre at the Club, and it's really, I think it's going to be something that grows and grows every single month. We're just going to do it like a monthly event.
Nice. It's a Wednesday?
Yeah. It's a Wednesday, I think, end of the month. Okay. Yeah, because obviously there was like a bit of controversy.
What's the word?
Yeah,
that's the word.
Controversy. Yeah. There's some issues about dropping the Kwaito charts. Because obviously YFM was sort of established through Kwaito music and stuff. And then, but there wasn't enough Kwaito music to start a chart. But now we're going to twist it on the people.
Okay.
And we're going to bring in Kwaito. You know that like Kwaito mixed with electronics?
Yeah. So that's another way. Like attention funky.
Yeah, exactly.
You know, that purple sound.
Dude, all of it. Like,
cool. Okay.
Matambo's pushing that. All of them. Like, okay, Malum, Cool Cat, so
Kwaito.
We're trying to bring that back. So that's another way of actually, in the end, we didn't drop the Kwaito chart, we're bringing it back and like giving it a second life and actually making it an international vibe instead of it just being Coco. Not actually breaking that international barrier, it's just staying a South African thing. So I think people are starting to take this bass driven electronic charts I'm pushing, the Hot 99 dubstep. It gets, the response gets better every day. So yeah, I'm happy.
Yeah, so would you say like, what else, is there anything else that you say we can do to like, get things right? Because there's this sense that the scene isn't quite on the right track.
Really? I think the scene's on the best track ever.
Best track.
Because now, Newtown is about to get that massive shopping centre. And Big Pick and Pay is going to make a huge difference. But Bramfontein, I mean, just walking here for the interview, I saw two new coffee shops that are open.
Yeah.
Even this place, I've never been here in my life. So, and it's all epic vibes, it's colourful, it's exciting, and more and more people are moving towards this scene. More people are coming back to town. They were out of town, now they're back. So I think we're doing the best with this movement.
Yeah, okay, cool. So on that track a little bit, we're in a country where something like 70% of the population are youth, are under 35. So in this kind of climate, what becomes important about club music, club culture?
That it is extremely experimental and not just closed off, like I like to say, in a box. You know, it's not just what we hear on radio only, it's what people, you know, just
more. So you're on radio, that's an interesting statement.
I know, but on radio I'm not playing like commercial stuff. I'm playing
the place.
Yeah, I'm not playing the place at all. It's all the stuff I want to put on, the stuff I hear people talk about in the streets, the stuff I hear on SoundCloud and different blogs, you know. And it's great that.
Who do you follow, like blog-wise, source-wise?
I like to check out trapmusic.net.
Okay.
And
trapmusic. .net symbol trap music.
Yeah, that's where you get that from. And then what other ones? There's so many. This song is sick. Do you know thisongissick.com? That's probably where I get most of my tunes from because it's just epic stuff. It's really like they're updated every single day. And then there's also I think freshesttracks.com as well. That's dope. But local ones, there aren't really any local blogs I check out for music. There's Kuda Cash's, his SoundCloud is epic. You can hear all the latest bass tunes there. So yeah, that's what I do.
Now, I heard whispering a little while ago about you moving into your own production.
What do you mean? What does that mean? Oh, like producing my own songs.
Yeah.
I got this machine. It's called the MK2. I don't know if you know Native Instruments. So it's like a drum pad machine thing. It's probably got every single sound you could think of. And I just got Logic Pro. And you know, I studied sound engineering. Mm-hmm. So, I mean, I studied this. And I put it on pause for a while, but now I think I'm going to start producing. Because what's a DJ? Like, you need to be able to produce the music as well. And I think it's better if you're at a festival and you're playing your own songs that you produce out of it. Or like remixes you've done of other people's songs instead of just other people's songs. It's definitely like an upgrade to my life. So yeah, I'm starting to produce a little bit.
Cool. Any time lapse on that?
No. I'm not putting a time on anything.
Okay, cool. So let's check around a little bit now. Party starters.
Oh god, party
this
starters.
Dog.
That was the, just me
do
being
you want to give
naughty.
Down on what is party starters?
Party starters, we tried to do this online. I think it's the future. Actually, I know it's the future. We tried to do this online reality show following five up-and-coming South African artists. There was one singer, there was a rapper, there was me, the DJ, there was a model, and a dancer. And like we're all still doing really well. So it was a good choice of five people. But unfortunately, like post-production wise, it wasn't working out. We might still get back together and push it again, but for now it's not working out. But we did put out, I think it was 3 episodes, and the response was quite dope because, I mean, lots of people in the Joburg scene know about us, so we started to watch things they know, see places they've been to, you know. But yeah, it's, for now that's on pause as well.
Yeah, so you go like get quite edgy in there.
I just when I drink, I just get reckless. I don't know. I think when I drink, I become a real Doowap. Like I'm Doowap.
Okay, so what is there something that changes?
I become ridiculously confident. Like nothing can stop me. I actually wish I was like that every day, but yeah, the cameras caught me. Party starters. It was sometimes
no
I was watching.
No regrets.
Oh, no regrets. Fuck that.
Nah.